With the
right, because Happy's in here.
Right, exactly. And the two or the three drow, after doing their movement, they fall back. Elsie clone.
Ugh.
If I have to reach for that reincarnate table again this session so soon,
it'll be really funny.
You're dodging.
He's dodging.
Yeah, I'm dodging.
Yeah.
Those are Azure. Okay, first one. I've got 16.
That does hit by one.
I can probably knock that off.
Okay.
But I don't know if I should wait for the... Well, they're at disadvantage, so crits.
Let's hope they don't crit.
Yeah, crits are unlikely at disadvantage.
Well, they're not. They're not at disadvantage. They cancel out.
Oh, okay. Well,
let me hit. Let me take that hit.
Sorry, I already did it. Okay. Well, I reduced it by 6 though.
Okay, so it misses.
Okay, second hit from that giant. 22.
Fine. I was gonna take one anyway.
Whoops. All right. Getting good practice for 7C because I'm matching 10s. 27 slashing damage from the first.
Ouch.
Giant. Here comes the second one. I got a non-natural 20 and a 29.
Yep.
Yeah, it sounds like I already knocked off the only one of those I possibly could have.
Yeah.
Fourteen from his first slash.
I might live.
27 from his second slash.
Never mind.
They are unconscious?
Yep.
The fire giants step forward, and they're very quickly conversing something in the giant tongue. The fire giants step forward and just plant Elsie clone into the ground.
I thought this was going to go down a lot differently, but never mind.
Okay. Everybody think about what you're going to do the next round. Because I must urinate. I'll be right back.
Elsie clone, where are you and what don't you have?
I feel, you know, like normally people would say, in what did we learn? And what didn't we learn?
Peach says, I'm right here and I don't have any of my blood.
So what's the rules on moving things while grappled? Do you move at half speed?
I think so. That sounds right. I think we've done.
I think that's the rules, because I read a thing like a year ago that was literally called the grappling.
Yeah,
handbook.
because in our Saturday game we just had somebody grapple the boss character and they moved them at their half speed.
Okay, so my current plan. Well, we were coming up with things we were going to do in the next turn.
Okay.
My current plan is to try to grapple one of these fire giants.
Yes.
And then use the rest of my movement to separate him from all the other things.
Okay. When do you go? When do you go? After me or before me?
Before you. Go after you. Me. Oh, after you then.
Okay. Because my plan is to cast,
Distant Whispers?
No, not Distant Whispers. The other one. Compulsion. Compulsion. On both fire giants, and get them to move back here and nail them to that wall.
Right now, it's Happy is up.
Yeah.
What's Happy doing? Nothing?
Hold on, are you muted? Muted?
No, I'm back.
Okay. What's Happy doing?
Happy, it moves up here.
That's
and
Dram.
Hey.
No, Dram's back here.
No, that's Happy.
No, Happy's over here, Brick Road.
Happy's been purple for weeks.
They're both purple.
They're both purple.
One of them's more pinkish though.
And well, we're going by names here.
Okay, we'll just swap them then. That way I don't get confused. Do that. So what's Happy doing?
The wrong names.
We'll change it.
Well, he's definitely not going to jump out and Well, actually, you know what? Can he move? Can he move here? Grab Elsie Clone, drag his dumb ass back into the...
Mm-hmm.
He will, but he will be leaving that fire giant's threat range doing so.
Fuck that noise.
So he's going to put himself behind that door?
Yep.
So he's not going to use a good berry.
Riot.
Okay. Riot's going to do exactly what I just said. Cast compulsion on these two fire giants.
What is that save? Wisdom, I imagine?
Wisdom, yeah.
God. 3 and 7.
Yes!
These fire giants get to act, but after that action, they are forced to move in this direction.
Okay. And you're moving or staying put?
I'm going to stay put for now. And give Serenity. I can't even see Kelian. I'm going to give Mahogany a Bardic Inspiration.
Okay.
Is that Bardic Inspiration meaning you think I should grab one of these fire giants, or should...
You definitely should not.
Dram. Okay.
Dram is going to... Dram has no idea what Riot is up to. Dram's going to...
Well...
Dram's going to plink away at these round.
Okay.
Let's see here. Hey, he's going to hit for once.
No way!
And then is he going to hit again? Probably not. Okay.
No?
So it's... No.
What's his bonus to hit?
It's plus 5.
Okay, then.
Yeah. Oh, snap. I just spilled water.
Oh, no. Is everything okay?
And that takes a mighty 6 damage. Try harder, Dram.
Dram is a try hard.
We lose Brick.
I think he's probably
dealing with the water.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, he probably went to get foul and stuff.
We've rolled the damage.
No.
I made a bad call. I'm sorry, everyone.
I don't forgive you. Our friendship is ruined.
So someone ought to get in there and good bury him, or he's going to die again in the second session in a row.
I'm still not used to the layout of this room, and my water is not sitting in the spot where I was expecting it. All right, so what did I miss?
This drought here took a mighty 6 damage.
6 damage. Big numbers, no whammies.
Right?
And what's Serenity up to?
Action trance. Move to here and shove a good berry down Elsie Clone's throat.
Okay. Elsie Clone, you regain a hit point.
Hey.
I'm going to flip him.
Good shit.
Elsie Clone, your turn.
Key point to disengage.
Okay.
And dart that guy, because I see scorch marks on him.
Okay.
Oh, there goes the black tile. You might want to delete that one, Brickroad. And dart fails.
Dart fails. Okay.
Yeah.
Kelian.
Hello.
What's up? Okay. I see what you're doing here.
Yeah.
arrow. I get it. Makes sense.
Oh, 16.
Nope. Hits their shield.
Cover.
Take cover. Mahogany.
So there's no delaying in 5th, right?
What do you mean by delay?
Like, move my turn to a later...
You have to take the ready action if you want to do that.
Alright. Well, fuck, you've made this horrible fire giant wall. Riot, and you won't let me hit them.
They'll be gone soon.
I guess dodge.
Okay.
2 key points.
All right. Mahogany. Did you pass or fail that fairy fire, Mahogany?
I failed.
You failed. All right, here comes.
Did anyone pass?
What was the DC on it?
I think just 13.
Oh, I passed it then.
Yeah, just 13.
I got a 13.
Mahogany. I'm going to hit you with a crossbow bolt. 7 points of piercing damage and make a Constitution 13 saving throw.
Okay.
Riot, you failed fairy fire.
Yep.
I also hit you with a crossbow bolt.
Okay.
10 points of piercing damage and make that Constitution 13.
What if we pass it?
If you pass it, nothing bad happens. And Elsie Clone, did you also fail the fairy? Yeah, you did.
Yep.
I also hit you with a crossbow bolt for the lowest possible damage, 5 points of piercing damage.
He's back down.
And make that Constitution saving throw.
What happens if you fail the Constitution?
Can he?
If you fit, yes, he can make it. If you fail it, you're poisoned for an hour, and if you fail it by a lot, you are unconscious while you're poisoned.
I failed it by 2.
Okay, so you're poisoned for an hour. That means disadvantage on attack rolls and ability checks. But that's all it means.
Okay. Fortunately, I passed my concentration save.
Okay. As the drow begin reloading their crossbows, it's going to bring us to fire giants. And I've got a nice, convenient target. Serenity, did you pass that fairy fire?
Yep.
Okay.
We're looking for a 15.
I got a crit.
I can take that down.
And I got a 25 with the first one. First great sword attack. Nice roll. Thirty-six from the first great sword attack. Second great sword attack. 24 from the second great sword attack. Here's the second giant. That's going to be a 14 misses and a 13 misses. Bad rolls.
That's not so bad.
As these giants just cleaving down into you with great swords. But they do not move. Oh, they have to move.
Oh, no, they have to move. They do forced move. To move.
Serenity, you can pick one if you want.
Can I hit him but not stop him? Not use my feature?
Sentinel feature?
This is an AO.
Right.
You don't have to.
You could use Sentinel if you
want. I can choose to not use it, though, right?
Yes. Because you have to use your reaction. You get to choose what to do with your reaction.
So that'll hit an armor class of 22.
That hits.
And it will deal... Nice. No rage, so... 17 damage.
17. I'm going to go to calc.exe. I'm glad that spill was just water and not my tea. That would have been gross. Okay. Happy.
Floor is yours, gentlemen.
Okay, so, that looks like... running into that is just asking to get beat, so Happy is going to not do that.
Okay.
Going to roll his eyes and grudgingly goodberry Elsie Clone.
Elsie Clone, you get a hit point back.
Yay.
And Happy says, I was saving that one asshole. Riot, you're up.
Okay.
I need to look at the DMG for something.
Riot recklessly walks forward.
Uh-oh.
And casts Thunderwave again.
Okay.
Oh man.
Let's see here. I gotta not forget to mark off these spell slots. So roll that those con saves.
Are you getting everybody?
I can't get everybody. I can get these two, though.
I thought it was a 20-foot square.
That's a 15-foot square.
Okay.
So originating from me, I can get these guys.
Okay. I rolled dick and balls on the con save. Well, 15. Does that 15 pass?
Nope.
No.
My DC's real high.
Okay, then dick and balls.
Okay. So, let's see here. I'm going to roll those 3d8s again. That's pretty good. 18.
18?
Mm-hmm. Push you. Push you. And then Riot goes back as far as movement allows, which is not far.
Okay. We need a word to describe the feeling you get when you use a calculator to do a math problem that you realize afterwards you could have just done in your head.
And then Riot yells out, Mahogany could use some help here.
Kelian. Dram looks at you, nudges you with his elbow as he comes in on the other side behind this cover. And he motions over to the south door and says, he's whispering to you. He says, that connects to the dining room, which connects to the main hall. I think a retreat may be in order. But he waits for your reaction.
Okay.
What's your immediate response? Like a one-liner, two-second response?
I think we're beyond retreating right now.
And he says that depends on how fast you can run.
Oh, that sounds like a challenge.
So what is Dram's action?
His action, he figures it can't hurt to lob another couple. What's that? Do I have him? I think I do. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 9, 10, 11, 12. Yeah, I've got the range to hit this guy.
Okay.
This seems like line of sight.
Yeah, it's fine.
So that's a no. Oh, wait. That was a no and a yes.
Okay, so what's the damage on that Eldritch Blast?
Dude, you have to go by what it's rolled as.
Well, yeah. The one rolled knocked the other.
It's just...
Let's see, so that's a 13.
13. Mm-hmm. Alright, that one is bloodied. That drow back there that you just blasted.
Mm-hmm. And where does he move? Because it sounds like...
You can move him. I'll let you decide what he wants to do. He's not going to move out into the open. He wants to retreat through that door.
He'll move here. Is he going to take damage from this?
No, not in that fire spot. He can take cover.
Then he's going to hide. Then he's kind of hide behind this cauldron.
Okay.
And keep motioning for Kelian. Like, come on, come on.
Serenity.
What's the reach on these fire giants?
10 feet.
Okay. To there and take a swing at this drow.
Okay.
Reckless attack. That's a crit.
Oh, nice. This is the one that has not been touched very much yet.
Yeah, he wasn't in the thunder wave.
Yeah. I think he passed the first one and then wasn't targeted in the second.
27 damage.
27. Decent, decent.
I'll attack him again. It's an armor class of 13.
No, 13 won't do it.
That's the end of Serenity's turn.
It's going to bring us to Unciclone.
Unciclone's rethinking his life choices.
You're only like 8 minutes old, dude.
I know, right? Pick stuff up here. Dart this guy.
Okay.
For all the good it's going to do. Because I'm going to miss anyway. Watch this. Yep, there it is.
And
12 is on. It's a 12.
Just hit his shield. Kelian.
Take it back. Take a step back.
Who do I have line of sight on from where I am?
This door here is closed. You can pop out and take a pot shot at basically anybody over here, but not this guy.
Not that guy. That's the guy I want, though.
Well, there are things we all
if
want.
If you moved up here, you probably could get it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You've got cunning action. You can basically cover the entire field in 2 turns.
1 turn.
Well, if you wanted to get in melee.
Let us out now. Okay, that guy. Where do I need to go?
You'd have to come over on the other side of these barrels here. The good news is you could then use those barrels for cover.
There we go. All right. I'm going to do this.
Okay.
That's how it works.
Yeah, that works.
Yeah, you're fine.
Not what I meant, but... Thank you.
One thing at a time. I mean...
And there's this Kelian special.
And the... Oh, you're not using the repeating crossbow anymore.
I'm not, no. This is not a goddamn thing.
And I can't give Kelian a belief point, right? I can't believe that he's going to make that shot. Okay.
Nobody believes that is the problem.
Mahogany, you're up.
All right, I've got just enough range to stay out of these fire pirates' range, but still help that drow.
Okay.
Well, I'm going to bite him. 18.
18, but he uses reaction to parry.
So what does that do?
That means he catches you, your fangs with his sword, and you don't connect.
Adds his proficiency bonus to his AC against the attack.
Yep.
Okay.
Neat.
Good news is he needs his reaction to do that.
Mm-hmm.
It's going to bring
us
to...
That's all I got, though. I guess I'll burn a first level spell to get some healing back.
Okay.
And then I'll end my turn.
These two drow say something else in giant, and the giants, this guy here, says something in response. And they both start to move this way. Disappearing around this corner. This guy here... Yeah, you know what? I'm going to have him disengage.
No, you're not.
Oh.
Sentinel.
Saw that coming. So do you get to attack him, or is he just nailed there?
I have to hit him. That'll hit a 19 on armor class.
Okay, and he can't parry again.
Nail him down.
And he's tries to move, but Serenity just blocks the way.
12 damage.
He didn't like that, by the way. He is also bloodied at this point. Fragiance. I think it's to go next. So, Are they still compelled to stay back here?
Oh, yeah. The spell lasts for a minute, I think. Yeah, a minute.
Okay.
They can act, but they can't move.
Gotcha.
Until I say they can.
If only there were boulders around for them to throw.
Can't rip a section out of the wall.
Happy, go.
So what's their range, just so I know?
10 feet. 10 feet, but they're back in the square against the wall there. Otherwise, they'd be attacking Serenity.
So they can't hit Serenity?
No, okay. Not from there.
Got it.
Right?
Serenity even stated that she was staying outside of that threat range.
Yeah, makes perfect sense.
Right wants to feel happy to go after those drow.
Happy wants to go... Okay, all right, then.
Well, Happy knows that will break the ring. And he says
That's... Trying to yell. Well, if he starts charging off, Serenity will yell off, remember the ring.
Yeah, that's true.
30 says he stops, skidding to a halt.
Okay. Riot.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Here. Can I... Is my tool.
Well, they're not actually standing in those squares. I just put them there so you know that they disappeared around that corner. They had more movement than that square. You can't see them from that point, no. Mm.
Okay.
No, they ran down the stairs.
Riot swears and says, now we're really in trouble. And she walks over and, actually, I'm going to make a persuasion check.
Okay.
Or I'm going to try to anyway. Messaging this fire giant.
Okay. What do you ask him to do?
Say, We're also on King Sodis' side. We don't want to hurt you.
Make that check at disadvantage.
Right.
Because all evidence is to the contrary.
Yeah. All right. I'm going to belief point that.
Are these the only belief points we have to spend this week?
These are the only ones I have to spend.
Okay.
Wow, really? Okay. Cool.
Still get to use the 10, though.
Yeah, so that's a 21.
21?
Mm-hmm.
That's pretty good.
And he gets to respond.
His response is that they will listen, but you will give them one life.
What? If I can message him, are we still in initiative order?
Oh yeah, we are. That was it.
I can wait. Okay. No. Yeah.
All right. I mean, because not only I'm not going to explain any further than that. Well, what's Riot's passive insight? She probably.
Her passive insight is 15.
Fire giants stand quite strongly on a weird kind of alien type of honor that Riot doesn't really understand. That doesn't make a lot of sense to people who aren't giants. And the issue is that you've shown them betrayal very recently. Mm-hmm. They, in order to kind of save face, they need something from you. And he's asking for one life.
All right.
Okay.
Right looks over at this dwarf, this drow here.
That's what they want, right?
Dram.
Let's see. Dram's got no targets. I mean, he has some, but he kind of like starts slipping out this way quietly.
No quiet way to open that
door. Oh yeah. And like pushes it open a crack.
Pushes it open just a crack.
Mm-hmm.
There's the dining hall beyond, and it does indeed connect to the great hall, which connects to the front door in freedom. No, the place is empty.
Okay. Then if he doesn't see anybody in there, then he goes through.
Okay, and let me get a quick description of this room for those of you who can see it now. Enormous, polished obsidian table surrounded by 8 giant-sized chairs. The stone basin in the back of the room, filled with lava, fills the room with an orange glow. And this set of iron doors here opens outward into the main hall. Serenity, you're up.
Let's keep pinning down this dude. So that'll hit. I'll take the 19.
I would.
Fifteen damage.
He's looking very bad after that hit.
Second attack. Great. Only 15 on the crit.
15 damage on the crit?
Yep.
That was enough. Pound him into smush. Moving or staying put?
Riot, there are... Like, it's kind of obvious when you're casting message because you keep flashing this mirror out, right?
Yeah.
I'll just sort of look at you and then look at the giant and say, we... What? And that'll be the end of Serenity's turn.
Elsie clone.
Staggers out toward the door here.
Okay.
And sees no overtly hostile action toward the giants yet, so he will dodge.
Well, I mean, you saw Riot shove him back against the wall.
No, all I saw was them take a swing of Serenity and then back off.
Alright, so you're going to dodge there. It's going to bring us to Kelian.
Kelian pops his head out ready to shoot any sort of drow he sees, but he doesn't see any drow.
No.
Well, he sees there's no drow to shoot.
There's a pile of dead one in front of Serenity.
Breaks Kelian's heart a little bit.
Mahogany, what's up?
Well, I want to go kind of get the lay of the land over here now. Apparently we're not killing giants. It's not giant killing day. So let's go see what's on the other side of this Iron Curtain right now.
Bear with me one second.
Jesus, here we go.
Alright, you just see the... Looking up down the hallway, currently empty. No, that's a lie. You see some dead azure corpses over in this direction.
Alright, do I still see the John Darr cube over here?
The dome? No, that has since faded.
Alright, then I'm going to
Jean
move
dome.
Back. Jean dome. And Mahogany just like sits there for a second thinking very hard. And then kind of writhes in place. He's trying to figure out how to shrug.
The giant booms something out in the giant language, but none of you understand him. He looks at Riot when he starts speaking, but then casts his glare over the rest of you too. And he's magically compelled to stay in place.
Yeah.
Happy.
It sounds dodging. Like we're not taking hostile actions until they do.
Well,
dodging.
They would.
I'm waiting
for
Riot to tell us what to do. Yeah. I mean, if Riot says they're pinned to the floor, you know, I'll start throwing javelins.
Riot, you're up.
All right. Riot walks over and points at the drow on the ground. Messages this one again. Says, "We're killing Drow for Alostro.
It was at
the Fire Giant Priest's request that we betrayed these Drow."
And the giant responds that Drow was his ally. And this insult can only be paid by the blood of one of your companions.
Riot says to the others, "I think we're at an impasse. Negotiations are failing."
Dram is going to make good his escape.
Yeah, I figured that was.
He's going to make his way out. So
Riot like kind of calculates a little bit and says, we've got less than a minute to pour on all the damage we can on these guys.
Serenity.
Just stay behind me when it breaks. I'll pull out one of my many, many new javelins and start throwing. Mm-hmm. First javelin. Glad I stocked up on these.
So how many rounds does it take before this breaks?
Well, it's a minute, so 10, right?
Okay, and they don't get to repeat their saves?
I don't think so. Do they? Let's see. Oh, no, they do. They get after moving this way, they can make another wisdom save.
Well, let me do that for this round. Because realistically, you're not going to get the full minute, even if I keep rolling twos and fives.
Yeah.
Okay.
First attack is 21 on armor class.
That hits.
Oh, but you can change the direction. That could be useful.
That's true. I can't do that.
For 8 damage, second attack, and this is on the wounded one.
Okay.
Is 15 on armor class.
Does not hit.
Okay.
Wearing plate armor.
Hey, Nick, remember when you talked me out of taking Sacred Flame earlier?
Yeah, I know.
Let me check my map one more. I gotta count some squares. That's a lot of squares.
I mean, the distance to Mount Celestia would eat up all your cleric casting anyway, wouldn't it?
Alright, so that was Serenity. We're going to go to Elsie Clone.
I'm going to dart the one that that Serenity just beat up.
Okay, good luck.
Nope. It's only a 14.
Moving or staying put?
I'm moving here.
Kelian.
Sorry, Kelian.
Which one is hurt?
This guy here that Serenity's just lob javelins at.
Yeah, I'll use one of the poison bolts on him.
Okay.
You can't get sneak attack, can I? Yeah, I'm gonna use one of the poison bolts.
Hey, he clears the constitution save, though.
Okay, cool. Well,
we'll see if you even hit, if it even was necessary.
Probably not. 13.
Bounces off his plate.
Yay.
Staying put?
Yeah.
What are you typing so furiously back there?
I'm just making some notes.
Okay. Moving or staying put, Kelian?
Okay. Why not, right?
Mahogany.
I think I'm going to come stand right here.
Okay.
Stay out of range, because there's no way for me to use my bite unless they can hit me.
Right.
And I am going to hold an action. If they move, if this giant moves forward, I'm going to bite him.
Okay. Actually, I'm going to... just to increase the tension of the table for the moment here, I'm going to put 8 counters down here.
Mm-hmm.
There they are. There's 8 of them. And now I'm taking one away.
I know what those counters are.
Friendship counters.
That's right. You got it.
Look at them wobble, man. Wow.
And they're wobbling like crazy.
Giants. All right. That's a wisdom save?
Yep.
I got a 12 and a 21.
21 breaks it.
And that's at the end of their turn?
At the end of their turn.
Okay. So the wounded one down here manages to break free.
Okay.
And he'll be able to step forward on his next attack.
Yeah.
Happy.
Happy? He doesn't want to. He doesn't want to do deal with this. He doesn't want to take point on this nonsense. He's gonna move back behind Mahogany and Serenity, and then once they take on this fire giant, he'll move in and pick them off from the side.
Okay.
Flank them.
Okay.
Riot.
Riot says, "All right, that one snapped. We got at least we got a horde of drow coming down on us because those two ran upstairs to the temple." Dram had the right idea. It's time to go.
And what's Riot's action?
Double move.
Double move. Serenity.
Alright. Move to there, peer out through the hallway.
And looking out through the hallway, you see that Dram has opened the door.
Mm-hmm.
And he is peeking underneath this iron curtain right here.
Mm-hmm.
That's what he's doing at the moment.
I've got 10 feet of movement left. I'll move to there.
Okay. The Unciclone.
Unciclone takes Riot, takes cue from Riot.
All right, so is that Elciclone Light or Elciclone Zero?
It's Diet Elciclone.
Diet
Elciclone. Elciclone Crystal.
I like the new. I like the Crystal Pepsi, man. I'm down with it. I'm enjoying it.
Let me count this out. 10, 20.
Serenity is just within 60 feet of us.
Let me ask this. Is there anybody who's not going to retreat? Is that the plan at this point? Because it looks like Elsie Clone's plan.
Yeah.
Kelian, are you also?
Yeah, I guess.
Okay. Mahogany, where are you moving to?
If we're going that way, I think the fastest way for me to move is actually to down to the right first.
Okay. Kelian, where are you moving to retreat? Down this way? Okay.
All right, now let me...
And Happy can get 80 feet.
Happy can get
some. Happy's turn.
I'm just kind of counting that out.
This fire giant gets to go first.
Oh, boy.
All right, Mr. Happy. Did he fail that fairy fire earlier?
Was he in it?
No,
I don't think he was in it.
He does. This is at disadvantage because of dodge.
He did dodge. All right. First attack. I've got a 17.
That's going to hit.
That's going to hit. We'll do the damage on that attack first. Fourteen slashing damage.
Okay.
And the second attack. Why am I rolling 40/20s? We don't need all of those. 17.
That's a hit.
Twenty-two slashing damage.
Just barely.
Did that knock him out?
Nope, he's here. He's still here.
He's still holding on.
He's up.
He's breaking his own balls. All right. It's Happy's turn now.
Key point to disengage.
Okay.
So... 30, 40, 50, 60, 70. Get him there.
Riot.
Okay. 2, 4, 6, 7, 8, 10. Okay, I can get to about here.
Okay. From this position, if everybody continues to dash, Giants cannot catch up with you.
Yeah.
Provided everybody's intention at this point is to dash out the front. If you're going in a different direction, speak now.
Nope.
No, the front seems good.
Front door sounds good.
Are we? Is Dram waiting up for us?
Dram is peeking behind this iron curtain here when you come out. When he sees the rest of you, he starts waving quickly.
Mm-hmm. Is he, like, waving for us to get underneath the iron curtain?
No, he's waving for you to follow him.
Okay.
Are we on initiative order?
Yes, for the time being. Assuming if you're going to stay and do anything, you will be, because the giants will be coming after you in like one or two rounds.
No, I think we're trying to book. I'm just trying to figure out if we need to like do this one person by one person, or if we can just.
And Serenity was going to involuntarily be at the back of the line in case anybody caught up with us, but other than that.
And my man here, I don't even think he can move the whole. Yeah, he can get under this curtain and out here to chase you, but that's that. I get to describe this door now. Because you guys came in the other direction. The door is 30 feet tall. 9 feet wide, each of the two doors, and smooth as glass. And you see on it are barely perceptible magical sigils, warding enchantments. Dram puts his hands to the door and speaks something in Ignan. The language of fire elementals. And you see a crack appear running the entire vertical length of the 30-foot door. And he pushes it open just far enough for himself to slip through.
What did he say?
Ryan's going to ask him. Can you teach me that?
A nonsense word in Ignan. Just a magic word.
I was just trying to learn it since I speak primordial, just in case we ever come this way again.
I figure we can ask him about it once we're on the other side.
Yeah. Okay.
When you get to the other side of the door, on the other side, this is the face of the Smiling Rock that you have not seen from the outside before. You've seen it from afar, but you haven't been here. Well, last time you saw it, though, it was guarded by Azers. This time, there are no guards. Dram ushers you through quickly, tells you the door will only remain open for a few seconds.
Okay.
Elciclon. We'll go through.
Yeah.
No sooner do the last of you get through that the door closes with a loud sound and seals down the center. What's your move from there?
Where was our? What was it in that was our hideout?
That was in the rookery, I believe.
Ah, yeah. Thanks. Okay.
How much longer is the Festival of Fire or whatever going on?
I didn't even open my calendar. Yeah, we're not in Sigil. I didn't think I would.
Actually, that's kind of an important note for me, actually, because today is Elsie Clone's birthday.
Oh my god!
Is it?
It is.
It is only because you died.
You only get a birthday present because you died.
Wait, we had a long rest. Yesterday is Elskoon's birthday.
Yeah, yeah.
He's one day old.
Yeah.
You've only been in the City of Brass. No, you were here for a couple days, yes?
Probably, I think a little less than a week.
Yeah.
From my recollection.
Right. And then you were down in the Smiling Rock for at least one long rest.
Yeah.
There was an astral day in this Ethel Rue, which doesn't always happen, which means it's one day longer. If you were to head back to Stigl right now, you would imagine it would be either Earth 1 or Ether 2. One of the two.
And how much longer do the gates stay open? After that?
I don't think the portal closes. It's just, this is when there's the most traffic.
Just pomp and circumstance here.
And we're also not worried about our route back because it's two Sigil. Two Sigil's no problem.
Getting to it from the City of Brass is pretty easy. The portal that you used to get here, if it's Earth 1 back in Sigil, will take 4 days. Earth 1, Ether 2, Death, and then Fire 2. The end of Fire 2, the portal will go away.
I mean, Serenity's opinion is we get off this plane immediately and come up with a new plan. And she thinks hiding out in Sigil is safer than hiding out in the City of Brass.
We're able to rest just as easily in Sigil that we are here, so.
Yeah.
Okay. Alright. Is that the plan?
Yeah.
Yep.
Alright. So here is the immediate fallout. Taking on Xandar's fortress ended in we'll call it a tactical retreat.
Yeah.
But we're all still alive. Oh, wait.
Yeah, we won't call it imminent failure or anything like that. Tactical retreat is what we'll use. Here's what you've accomplished. You know for a fact that you managed to almost deplete, if not obliterate, Xandar's hobgoblin forces. You know this because they came spilling out of that last barracks you were at, and only four of them came out.
Yeah.
You reduced their number by quite a bit. As far as you're standing with the drow and the other fire giants, they're very, very spotty. Chances are when you go back in, any attempt to strike a deal with those two factions is going to be met with violence. So.
Do any of us know that, though, except for Riot?
Riot will explain what happened with it. Like, what the fire giant wanted, why she didn't give it to him. Etc. Etc.
Why didn't we just talk to the drow?
Because we already had an arrangement with the other fire giants, who I thought were going to be on the same side as these, but weren't, to kill as many drow as we could.
Right.
Yeah.
I would think you more than anyone would know that not all members of a race are working together.
So my next question, and this might be the last question for tonight, is. Is the plan of the group to immediately find a way back into the Smiling Rock and finish what you started? Like, within next day.
Kelian, do you need to go back?
Yeah, okay. I still need that hammer.
Yeah, the guy is on Kelian, so Serenity's going to do whatever she can to help him.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, so this is Mahogany's baseline plan here.
Mm-hmm.
We killed the shit out of most of that building.
Mm-hmm.
And we provably did so because that place is in disrepair. The only reason that other fire giant wouldn't help us is because we couldn't prove that we could fuck with that building. We did so. We should just talk with them, get like a bunch of fire giants, roll in there.
But weren't the two fire giants we were fighting at the end from them?
No. They were working for Asel Sodius. He said that a bunch of other people working for Asel Sodius didn't join in hating Xandar. He looked down on that.
It really, well, the problem is we have to figure out whose alliance we want to keep. Right now we're in kind of a tacit agreement with what's his name? Alostro. And Alostro's enemies are the drow. We don't have any arrangement right now with the other guy. Zudvog.
I don't see any reason why Zudvog and Alostro can't make a deal. They don't seem to hate each other the way that the drow and what's his name does, Alostro.
So as to the drow, their offer that their priestess wants to take control of the rock, we're we're disregarding that. There's no chance of wanting to work with these drow.
Yeah, no.
We're right, on the same page about that.
Yeah, because we already cast in our lot with Elostris.
Okay.
Yeah.
What I think we should do, I think you have the germ of a good idea. What I think we should do is go back to Elostro and tell him, look, we tried to kill some drow, and this is the difficulty we ran into. Can you help us at all in killing other drow?
That seems like a real bad plan. Mm-hmm. Because yeah. His whole thing is that he doesn't think we're strong enough. We tell him we didn't kill three drow. Like, that's a bad plan.
Yeah.
Okay, we tell him we did kill four drow. And some other drow ran away from us. We want his help in tracking down the cowards who ran from us, and also in negotiating with these fire giants who are in there.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah.
I like that idea.
So, the rest that you're going to take, are you going to take a rest in the City of Brass, or are you going to head back to Sigil?
Rat Hole.
Rat Hole, I think.
Really? Rat Hole? Rat Hole's a long way away.
What's wrong with
you? Do you have a date tonight or something?
Do we really feel that unsecure in the City of Brass?
Well,
yes.
Okay.
I don't see...
And here's why. Jandar is going... We know, we have seen how much Jandar is operating under the table. For him to bring to bear the security arrangements of the City of Brass on us would require him to admit to a lot of stuff that he doesn't want to admit to.
Or call in a favor. Who knows how many dirty officials are under his thumb. Or even just have one favor.
So here's what Dram offers to do. Because he has unfinished business in there as well. And he feels he owes a great debt of gratitude to all of you. However, he has nothing. He's got no money, none of his equipment. He says, if you give him some gold, for about 60 gold, he can procure a scroll of Nock to bust those prison doors open when you guys go back in.
Riot scoffs. He says, we don't need no scrolls for Nock.
Nock's kind of her whole thing.
And then the next question is, then why didn't you bust the prison doors while you were in there?
Our exit wasn't secure at the time.
Which prison doors is he talking about?
About the prison
doors. The ones
doors
on the lower
the...
floor.
Yeah.
The ones where all the slaves are being kept?
Where you needed the password to get someone to open them on the other side?
He tells you that the earth elemental that attacked you came from inside that prison compound. They came straight in through the walls. Jandar has, like many Dao, have the ability not to just to construct or summon earth elementals, but to imbue them with magics that make them more powerful than the standard kind. He says if you give him 3 days in the City of Brass, he can gear himself up, be ready to go back in so he can finish his job.
And you're going to be free the slaves?
And he nods.
Then I'm inclined to give you what you need.
Yeah, agreed.
I mean, what if I give you... A second here to look at my character sheet. I don't have much money. Oh, wait, no. We're in the hidey hole. What if I give you...
I've got some money.
No, I forgot. My money's all in the hidey hole. So,
Dram's not going back to Sigil.
Okay. How long does it take to get to Sigil? Because I think we're working under two different ideas of time here.
Probably 6 or 8 hours.
Oh, I thought you said it would take 4 days to get there.
No, in 4 days, the common portal you're using closes, because that's the end of the festival. Okay.
All right, that's what I wanted to clarify.
Yes.
All right.
Yeah. I mean, if you give me a list, I can get whatever you need at the... Even if you don't want to go to Sigil, I can go to the marketplace.
I'll put it this way. If you're going to make the journey back or forth after that 4 days is over, you no longer have an easy portal. You're going to have to do some research to find another portal to use.
Right.
Yeah. Yeah, no, I think 4 days ought to be enough for us, I figure.
Okay.
But yeah,
I'm going to stay with Dram here. I don't feel like going back to Sigil.
Okay. I'll tell Dram if he needs shopping done quicker, I can always go to the Great Marketplace for him. Just give me a list. I'll pay for it.
Oh, he's got contacts in the City of Brass that he can handle. He can get his gear and stuff on his own.
Okay.
It was just the expensive spell scroll he wasn't sure he would be able to get.
All right. That 4 days seems like a long time to me. I can just go and ask the in-depths and probably have it all in a couple hours.
But to physically get to the portal and then back to Sigil, you're talking about 6 or 8 hours.
Yeah.
That's a long journey. Okay, Sue. Everybody's heading back to Sigil except Riot. Did I hear that correctly?
The Tiefling is staying behind as well with Riot.
Kelian said,
Okay, as long as Riot isn't going to be here by herself, then.
Okay.
Kelian will also go back to Sigil.
What? I'm going to ask him what he uses as an implement. Like, what kind of... What does he roll with? What kind of equipment is he going to get?
Just some standard armor.
I don't see any reason why we don't loan him the Wand of the War Mage I have in the shop. Any spellcaster can attune to it. He'll get a plus one to all his attack rolls.
He will absolutely not turn down a magic item.
Yeah, like, I'm making clear this is a loner, but it's going to help him take out his friends.
Okay, let's do this. Because I want to go ahead and give out some experience and do a belief rundown.
Yeah.
And then in the post-game, you can all compile your notes about what you want to start at the beginning of the next session. Yeah. Here's the thing. The plan was not to immediately go back in. I was going to call it there. That was the end of Act 1. And then the fallout of your failure to complete your mission would have been the opening of Act 2. But no, since everybody's resolved to go back in, yeah. Get back into that fight. Does everybody have a healthier respect for fire giants now?
I think we could have taken them, and I think Riot running made us in a worse situation.
That's how
Mahogany takes it.
The reason we ran wasn't the fire giants, it was the drow. We don't know how many drow there were, and we knew that all of them would be coming after us.
Yep. That was the point of the marbles. That's how many rounds you had.
Yep. I figured that immediately. I had no doubt that we could have taken out those fire giants.
They're really difficult.
I don't know. Fire giants
are really difficult.
One of them was in a situation where he couldn't hurt us. And let me just roll some dice real quick. On the first round.
And we were spent too. Like, we were running low.
Mahogany constricts one of the other ones so he can't attack for a full round. I think we could have taken him.
I think we probably could have taken him, but it would have been dicey.
It was the drow, not the fire giants, that I respected.
Yeah. Yeah.
I love that this is Mahogany's new thing.
There are so many types of monsters in this dungeon that you guys haven't even fought yet.
Ancient fire dragon.
Oh man, I'm going to start making lists of things. If Rick's going to start letting me pick creatures for summoning, we're going to see a lot dumber shit going down.
Ooh, yeah. I mean...
We're going to see gargoyle traps. We're going to see riding on spiders.
Alright, I'm going to make a quick straw poll here.
I've got animal handling. I'll be damned if I don't get use out of riding on some spiders. I've been wanting to use the animal handling skill all game.
Alright, here comes the poll for Twitch chat. Just vote for the player you liked the best this week. This player will get a little bit of... I'm not adding Mr. Toad to the straw poll.
I will take all votes for Mr. Toad. Just send those right over to Mahogany.
And let me get my... There it is. Okay. So we do give a blip for creativity. What was the most creative action this session?
Oh, there was one too, and I can't remember what it was.
I had to write them down during the session so I don't have to review 4 hours of play.
I assumed you guys were doing that.
That's way too responsible.
I think it makes more sense if people think they did something to not feel bad about putting yourself forward.
No, absolutely put yourself forward.
Yeah.
Yeah, what are you talking about?
So that way we can remember things. Like, it's not like, oh, I think I'm the best. It's, this is a cool thing that happened.
I'm going to finish cleaning up this water. I'll be back in 60 seconds.
Okay. So I'm thinking creative. The elk was a good idea. To at least keep that guy from retreating.
That's
even
what
though,
it was.
Even though
you turned
it
into an elk
failed.
And
you know what else was good? The elk is good. But also, the even though it didn't go off, I like the trap a lot. The bear trap. I thought that,
that was
a really
creative.
Good idea.
That was creative. Yeah.
I like the elk darkness. Because it caught up to the other captain and allowed Kelian to get sneak attack damage on him.
I think inevitably, yeah, that's probably the more
effective
action. Yeah.
Yeah.
Since it actually ended up, it wasn't a complete success, but it wasn't. I mean, nothing against you, Destil. It's just the trap.
Oh, I'm currently thinking of the trap for other things now because I fully respect someone going through their big list of stupid shit and trying to figure out what they can use.
Amen. All right, Brooke, we got creativity. It's going to be Nodal for the for being the elk.
Okay. We do one blip for the assist blip. Who furthered the party's goals the most?
Riot.
For sounding the retreat?
Yes.
Actually, yes. Yeah. I can do that.
Yeah. Riot assessed the situation correctly and said, no, which is no win for us.
Well, let's be clear. Dram assessed the situation correctly and then Riot agreed with him.
Riot was controlling Dram.
Right.
No, Dram didn't run from the drow, though. Riot ran from the drow.
I mean, it was also, hey, don't attack the fire giants, just attack the drow, because we have the deal with the drow. With the fire giants, I mean.
Yeah.
What about the badass blip? Who was a badass?
I'm pointedly not giving it to Elsie Clone.
No,
This is like me rubbing his nose in his mess.
No, that's totally fair.
Alright, so I know I already got one, but I want to at least say this out loud. Turning into a snake and grabbing that rock dude was rad as shit.
It was pretty badass. Followed up with the crit grab, that was also, yeah, no, I'm totally down for that.
All right,
so. I'll vote for anyone else because I already got one, but I just wanted to say it.
Are we down with Mahogany for the badass?
Yeah.
Okay. Alright, intangibles. What other reasons are we going to give one this week?
I like the trap.
Yeah, if
anyone else has a better.
Track, yeah. I have to mark that off my character sheet.
Oh, you never got it back!
Nope.
Yeah.
You fool! Oh, well, we were going back into single. Write down magical trap.
You know Brick's gonna throw that back in our face when we go back into that dungeon, right?
We're immediately gonna walk into a trap.
Yeah.
It's gonna be all bear traps all the way down.
Yeah. It's just going to be bear traps.
Someone was just casting creation for like a good 5 years, just going, bear trap, bear trap, bear trap.
Zhendar picked it up and was just like, this is cool, and just created 10 more.
Well, he's got a forge downstairs, so yeah, no, easy peasy.
Alright, let's do
25-foot cube, giant-sized bear trap.
Real quick.
Kelian first.
Okay, Kelian first.
Three nose.
That was super easy.
Yep.
Who's next?
The tiefling.
Okay, Nazi clone.
The tiefling.
What's Nazi clone's belief?
Nazi clone's belief is it's not enough to go for the quick fix. I have to solve the root problem.
Okay, let me make a note of that here.
That's a good belief.
That sounds pretty good. Okay, and did he embody that belief this session?
I would say no.
How so?
Well, see, because he thought that he was trying to go for the problem in the immediate problem of trying to, well, it's like he tried but didn't, because he was like, "Don't worry, I have a plan," and then he realized, "Oh wait, I haven't thought that far ahead." Okay. So he's learning something from that belief.
So what is he learning?
What he's learning is that you need to think more than six steps ahead in order to come up with a really proper plan.
Okay.
Instead of just, okay, just coming up with it on the fly, that isn't going to work.
And the belief's not old enough for it to start changing yet, so we're going to skip that one this week. Who's next?
Mm-hmm. I'll go.
Riots.
So I realized, last week I said my belief changed, and I realized between sessions that the reason it's changing is because being on the plane of fire is about as far from the influence of a sea god as you can get.
Right.
So that's why Osprey has less hold on her belief in anymore.
Okay.
Her
so,
new belief is laws are best followed in a manner that demonstrates their absurdity.
That demonstrates their absurdity?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, no, Nich and I, we were trying to come up with something
that would make me more lawful, but still hold to that old Riot spirit.
Okay. Did Riot embody that new belief this week?
Didn't come up.
Didn't come up. Okay. And Serenity, I guess you're next.
No.
Mahogany.
Yeah, I don't think any of mine came up.
Okay, so El Ciclone and Riot can take a belief point for the change and for the new belief.
I think I took mine last week, but I don't remember if you gave it to me then.
I gave it to you last week.
You did. Okay.
Yeah. All right, let's go to the straw poll real quick.
that's a thing.
Mahogany wins the straw poll by a lot. Mahogany, you must have been really, really good this week.
No, I just have 9 devices.
You just have what?
Yeah, I just have. I've got like 9 phones.
Oh yeah, yeah, that's cool.
Yeah.
All right. Everybody takes 1,000 experience for the encounters. That factors in the hobos, the one captain, 2 earth elementals, and the drow that you killed. Split 7 ways.
Wait, so 1,000 split 7 ways?
No, 1,000 is after the split.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
I am going to award... I'm going to award everybody an extra blip on top of... Not a whole blip. I mean, it's not worth a whole blip. I'll award everybody an extra 100 for recognizing the need to sound the tactical retreat. Staying and fighting was not the winning strategy there.
No.
Riots. I got you down for the assist blip, plus I gave you one for your flaw. I don't trust anybody but me not to fuck everything up. You took a chance to trust LC Clone for a split second and immediately realized he didn't have a plan. And you were kicking yourself afterwards.
Yep.
LC Clone, I awarded you a blip. I never enter a room without backup. The one time you stepped into danger this session with sketchy backup, you got knocked unconscious twice.
Yep.
So you can take that one. Serenity, I gave you your This There Is Only Now blip. For dashing out behind the Iron Curtain. You're also taking intangibles and mahogany. I didn't give you anything, but you're taking creative, badass, and the straw pole.
What are the blips worth right now?
They are worth 700.